our discussions touched upon all subjects which are of shared interest to us, and other issues like energy security, food security, and environment. There is an enthusiastic interest in both the countries among the industry leaders. The CEOs Forum, which we have established, which had met in a structured manner during the visit of Her Excellency Prime Minister Julia Gillard of Australia recently, have made very focused recommendations to the two governments, which we have agreed to consider as we move forward on the roadmap of our bilateral partnership. We have also visited the issues of enhanced investments. The Indian investments in Australia are reaching close to $20 billion. The Australian investments are also definitely moving upward of $4 billion. But there are many pending proposals which have been flagged to our attention, which need early decisions for wherever approval on land-related issues, we shall get addressed. The trade, both in services and in merchandise trade put together, is in excess of $20 billion. That's the number of last year. I and Dr. Craig Emerson have discussed the issues how to strike a balance in the trade so that there is more market access, particularly in the pharmaceutical industry, where India has strengths in generics, also in light engineering, and in the textile sector. We have also talked about the professionals movements, a large number of Indian students who are studying in Australia. Many of them have become part of the big pool that Australia have of immigrant skilled persons or professionals.
Australia-India relations, I think the friendship that you and I have developed and the cooperation that we've been able to enjoy, not only in the bilateral relationship but on the broader international stage, is a testament to our shared values, our shared system, and that friendship that we have developed over the years. We did have, a genuinely productive joint ministerial meeting. We did get down into some detail, which I think does benefit officials because they know that they have the authority of ministers of our governments to proceed down particular pathways. But all of this was done in the context of a briefing that I gave Anand and officials on our white paper on Australia in the Asian century. This was prepared and released in October of last year, and it is a genuine commitment to diversify our economy by tapping into the growth of huge economies such as India's, not just, as you've indicated, in the export of minerals and energy to help meet India's energy security needs, as important as they are, and there are wonderful opportunities, but to diversify into food production, food processing, and the various service industries. This is the theme of the white paper, but there's no stronger commitment in the white paper than that, which is to the investing in the talents of our young people. We will have, as a result of the work that we're doing, not only high commissioners and officials in their official capacity, but hundreds of thousands of ambassadors to each other's countries as young people from India study in Australia, and increasingly we want to reciprocate that and have young people from Australia studying at least part of their degrees or further degrees in India.